Twitter and Facebook take to the same platform to talk to a group of entertainment marketers who are focused on TV, digital, and the multiple screens being utilized by automotive companies.
Twitter, from a marketer's perspective, is the diversity of use cases that it can accommodate. So I know that probably most of us in the room who have worked with our platform probably first engaged around the angle of PR or the idea of trending. And although that remains important to us, we've supplemented that with paid marketing opportunities that again suit different objectives. Things like retargeting people who have likely seen your TV ad based on what we know that they're talking about. So if you're running in the Big Bang Theory and we see people tweeting about Jim Parsons, we're going to introduce an ad to them that adds another layer of social frequency on top of that. So again, diversity of objectives, and I think a strong record of early evidence that there are outcomes that are successful against each of them.
I think, you know, one thing that definitely needs to be focused on, you brought it up at the beginning, you know, the platforms that we have are quite large, especially compared to other kind of offline channels. And I think across all of those objectives, there should be a focus on scale. I mean, most of the auto OEMs in this room, probably build their business on selling more than one, than just kind of one vehicle. Right, you're trying to sell thousands, hundreds of thousands, millions of vehicles. I think Steve's comments around the growth in the marketplace and the focus on that scale piece is really important. And so across all of those different marketing objectives, you know, doing small programs is good, but doing very large programs that make a measurable difference on your business is really where the focus should be.